Nearly every time I tell people I am a financial planner, the first thing that most people ask revolves around investing. I take a deep breath and I try not to sigh. They need to be educated. I'm Mitchell Hockenbury, and I'm going to explain to you why your investments aren't that important. What I'm about to explain is probably the second most important aspect of your financial life. The first is to spend less than you make. If you don't, the debts pile and bankruptcy is down the road. The next most important principle is this: your savings rate is crucial. It dictates when you will be able to choose to stop working, choose how to live, and choose how to think about your position in this world. Let me explain. First, let's begin with what the savings rate really is. This is the percentage of your pay you save. If your monthly income is $5,000 and you save $1,000, your savings rate is 20%. If you save $500, it's 10%. It's pretty easy math. Now, why is this important? Because the higher percentage of your pay you save, the less you have to spend. Well, let me say that again. The higher your savings rate, the less you spend. This is a powerful principle to learn. Most people look at it from the wrong lens. They think higher savings rate, higher savings amount. And although that is a true statement, the more important principle is spending less money. My man Dave Ramsey has a saying: it's never an earnings problem, it's always a spending problem. That is right on. And to take it to the next level, if you save huge percentages of your income, you live on less. You get used to that lifestyle, and soon, really soon, you can choose to quit working altogether. That is freedom. The freedom to choose. The freedom to do the things that you are passionate. The investments? No, they're simply there to assist. It is only one variable. So let me put you through a thought experiment. If you save 10% of your income, in 10 years you will have 1 year's worth of income. Make sense? I'm taking interest and investment gains out of this whole thing. So if you save 1/10, after 10 years you will have 10/10, so a full year's worth of income. This is what you are planning to live off of in retirement, which is why it takes 40 years for you to have enough to live off in retirement. But what if you saved a whole lot more, like 50%? Well, if you save 50% of your income and earn 10% return on your savings, in 12 years, you will have enough to choose to stop working. You are financially independent. Do you see why the savings rate is the most important thing? Imagine you only need to work 12 more years and now you are free to follow your passions. I have much more to say on this and have hung some resources at personalfinancemadeclear.com. Head over there, and if you haven't subscribed yet to the Personal Finance Made Clear YouTube channel, please do so. It really does help. Thanks.